now to the near side. Shaw once again on it. Held in at the line. Now right in front, there's a shot by Dumba, and it's redirected out of play as Mrazek gets a piece of it.
Young guys, and Dewar and Shaw, and they're able to get a chance. But it was all about the previous shift and Sammy Walker and using his speed. And there you can see the cycle trying to develop.
Can't be held in there at the line by Dumba. And here we go. Sam Lafferty works his way in, cuts in, but it's Fleury with the kick save. Addison sends it across ice. Here's Kaprizov. He drops it down. Addison recollects. Puts it back. Here's Steele. Sends it across ice. There's a shot down low. Directed in.
Staying connected, but as soon as the Minnesota Wild bring the puck up high, they use their defense so well here. They spread them out and watch the room that opens up for Kaprizov. And Jonathan Toews is well aware of where he is. He was following him the entire time. They were playing man on man, but when they extended.
So we've played over just 9 minutes here in the first, and here we go. Here's Steele on it, takes the shot, but it's turned aside by Mrazek.
The play quick develop, and you can see right here from his own zone, Dumba just finds Sam Steele, and it's a little bit of a...
Not at all. 7-3 was the final in that contest. As the Blackhawks have dropped at 5 straight, looking to fix that tonight. There's a long shot coming off the stick of Caleb Jones, and Fleury's forced to be sharp, not once, but twice. The puck popped up, and now Addison has it on his stick. Their power play has 4 goals in the past 4 consecutive games, and here's Eric Zanette, takes the shot, Mrazek with the save, rebound out to Boldy. Back to Addison, sends it there, looking for the one-timer, doesn't get it. Zuccarello has it on his stick, the goal scorer here for the Wild. Kaprizov sends it low, there's the shot back door, and a save by Mrazek. Puck rattled around to the near side, Wild will get there first, they will exit out of the zone, and here comes Shaw, takes the clapper, and Mrazek forced to glove it down. Boldy sends it cross ice, back to Boldy. He's dancing inside the line, leaves it for Kaprizov, sends it down low. There's a shot, but Mrazek with the quick glove as he covers it. Here's Dickinson, being watched by Addison. He rolls it around, but Miro once again on it. He would just drop it back, but right now in front, there's a shot by Dickinson, but Fleury with the save. Back on October 30th, in a 4-3 shootout win. All right, off and running here in the second period. The Wild up 1-0. Steele up top. Here's Spurgeon, puts it towards net. Mrazek with the save on the rebound, and Mrazek gets back for a great save.
Covered Chicago in LA when he came back.
McCabe trying to locate it in his skates as he's taken down on the play, and here comes the Wild. Boldy with the shot, Mrazek, another save, and this time he will hold on. Connor Murphy working away for it for Chicago in the corner, now right out front to the high slot. Dumba blasts it towards the net, looking for the redirect from Steele. Dangerous play, here's Kaprizov, turns, fires, they chip another one at Mrazek. He's down and the puck is in the net.
It was a short side shot on Peter Mrazek. And he loses his post ever so slightly right here, and it squeaks in, and he recognizes that maybe I have it, maybe I don't, and Kaprizov recognizes that he doesn't, and he finds it, and he's able to tip it in, and the Wild are lucky that there was no whistle. You know, looking at that replay, I don't think it was in initially from that short side shot. As the Wild just move it around, and again, the seams wide open. You can see Dumba moving it down low. And right here, watch Kaprizov just sneak in, pokes it.
Comes the Wild shorthanded. It's Eriksson-Ek. He has Gaudreau with him, tries to take the shot. It's blocked by Seth Jones. Did that go in? No! Addison begins out for his team, drops it back for Boldy. He will send it into Chicago's zone. Eriksson-Ek puts it down over Boldy, sends it across, back door, and he scores!
Been too easy, they've come too often, and I know Chicago's on the penalty kill, but they're unable to get the puck out, and then just watch the open ice. And Zuccarello could have held that puck for another 5 seconds. I think that net still would have been wide open, but it's a tic-tac and toe top shelf. Yeah, just 5 minutes and 45 seconds short of his season high, which ironically was the last game against Minnesota. He played 22:57.
And it's held in by McCabe. He wheels it around to Seth Jones at the point. Back along the half wall for Blackwell, sends it across. Down low, there's a shot on net as McCabe was pinching in, but Fleury with the save. There as it was intercepted. And the Blackhawks will just spin this one right around. Domi slides it across for Kane. Kane puts it towards the net. Fleury with the save. He continues to battle away.
Slides right towards his stick and doesn't allow him to make the play. And here's the little hook there, and trying to create something from a defensive side of things.
So Chicago back on the power play, and they score! Redirected in front.
Exactly what happens here for the Chicago Blackhawks. Jonathan Toews wins the draw. We've seen that time and time again, but this is just a simple shot here. And there you can see it. It goes right off Merrill and squeaks through the five hole of Marc-Andre Fleury. As Kane was looking down to Domi for that pass, it goes off the backhand side of Jonathan Toews and sort of went to defend his teammate. Ben Chiarot stepped up as well for Detroit.
What a save right there by Mrazek.
Peter Mrazek doing.
That puck is collected by McCabe and he will skate it out, but right back to the stick of Kaprizov. He has numbers. Kaprizov takes the shot. Mrazek turns it aside. Dumba at the line. He'll drop this one back. Wild circling around. Greenway sends it across. There's a shot by Ek and it's off the post. Now here goes Mrazek for the extra attacker. There's a shot right in front and Fleury with a save on Jonathan Toews. And that puck will clear it. Does it hit the net? Just wide, but chasing after Zuccarello, and he puts it in! And the hats will fly as Matt Zuccarello records the hat trick for the first time since October 30th of 2015.
And he negates the icing. And you can see he's all the way down the ice, just waits for it to come off the boards, and just a simple play for him to put it in the net. Who's more happier, Zuccarello or Kaprizov?
Just under 2 minutes to play here in the third period. Right out in front, and there's a shot coming off the stick of Reeves, but Mrazek was there, and as they will earn their sixth straight win here on home ice, and they improve to 7-2 in the month of December.